What is going on, guys? Welcome back to another one. Today we are doing I America is not the greatest country in the world anymore. Yep, definitely there was a time where they were the greatest. I'm sure, because there are so many people that live in that mentality that America is the greatest in the world. But let's see what this has for us. Yeah, apparently it's not a real interview. Apparently it's just like I filmed something. Yeah, that was what something. So,
okay.
So let's see.
Go on to the next question.
Like scripted.
Yes, sir. My name's Steven. I'm a junior, and my question's for Will McAvoy. Do you consider yourself a Democrat, a Republican, or an independent?
I consider myself a New York Jets fan, Steven. Since it's been brought up, you've almost religiously avoided stating or even implying a political allegiance. Is that because, as a news anchor, you feel the integrity of your broadcast would be compromised?
That sounds like a good answer. I'll take it.
There was a short piece on Vanity Fair's website by Marshall Westbrook. You probably saw it, where he calls you the Jay Leno of news anchors. You're popular because you don't bother anyone.
Yeah.
How do you feel about that?
Jealous of the size of Jay's audience.
Are you willing to say here tonight whether you lean right or left?
I voted for candidates run by both major parties.
Let's move on to the next question. Go ahead.
He doesn't want to give.
My name is Jenny. Sorry. I'm a sophomore, and this is for all three of you. Can you say in one sentence or less what? you know what I mean. Can you say why America is the greatest country in the world?
Diversity and opportunity.
Lewis?
Freedom and freedom. So let's keep it that way.
Will?
The New York Jets.
No, I'm gonna hold you to an answer on that. What makes America the greatest country in the world?
Well, Lewis and Sharon said it, diversity and opportunity and freedom and freedom.
But there is no freedom for diversity.
Really?
I mean...
In the US?
Immigrants are not really welcomed, I guess.
I mean,
I couldn't explain myself, but...
Yeah, I think it's because of what we hear from outside the country, like,
like
for
the
black
news.
People cases and the Mexicans cases and all. Yeah,
and racist issues.
Yeah. I get what you mean.
But I only know the news, so maybe it's not objective. That's
why. You don't look satisfied.
I want a human moment from you. What about the people? Why is America
not the greatest country in the world, Professor? That's my answer.
You're saying
yes.
You're... Let's talk about
fine. Sharon, the NEA is a loser. Yeah, it accounts for a penny out of our paycheck, but he gets to hit you with it anytime he wants. It doesn't cost money. It costs votes. It costs airtime and column inches. You know why people don't like liberals? Because they lose. If liberals are so fucking smart, how come they lose so goddamn always?
Hey!
And with a straight face, you're gonna tell students that America is so star-spangled awesome that we're the only ones in the world who have freedom? Canada has freedom. Japan has freedom. The UK, France, Italy, Germany, Spain, Australia, Belgium has freedom. So 207 sovereign states in the world, like 180 of them have freedom.
All right.
And yeah, you, sorority girl, just in case you accidentally wander into a voting booth one day, there's some things you should know, and one of them is, there is absolutely no evidence to support the statement that we're the greatest country in the world. We're 7th in literacy, 27th in math, 22nd in science, 49th in life expectancy, 178th in infant mortality, 3rd in median household income, number 4 in labor force, and number 4 in exports. We lead the world in only 3 categories: number of incarcerated citizens per capita, number of adults who believe angels are real, and defense spending, where we spend more than the next 26 countries combined, 25 of whom are allies. Now, none of this is the fault of a 20-year-old college student, but you nonetheless are, without a doubt, a member of the worst period generation period ever period. So when you ask what makes us the greatest country in the world, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. Yosemite?
The mic drop. Okay, now that was so badass. Like, this is probably why he didn't talk. He didn't say anything. You know, this kind of people,
yeah,
where they just explode.
He was keeping so many things inside.
Yeah.
And he suddenly exploded.
Yeah. And it feels like a coke that you've shaken and shaken and shaken. Oh, it's crazy, man. Love it.
Sure used to be.
Oh.
We stood up for what was right. We fought for moral reasons. We passed laws, struck down laws for moral reasons. We waged wars on poverty, not poor people.
Mm.
We sacrificed. We cared about our neighbors. We put our money where our mouths were, and we never beat our chest. We built great big things, made ungodly technological advances, explored the universe, cured diseases, and we cultivated the world's greatest artists and the world's greatest economy.
Wow.
We reached for the stars, acted like men. We aspired to intelligence. We didn't belittle it. It didn't make us feel inferior.
Hmm.
We didn't identify ourselves by who we voted for in the last election, and we didn't scare so easy. We were able to be all these things and do all these things because we were informed by great men, men who were revered. First step in solving any problem is recognizing there is one.
Mm.
America is not the greatest country in the world anymore.
Wow.
Enough?
Enough?
Bro, what a video.
I
what
think
a...
I
For example, if someone didn't tell me this was like scripted and
mm-hmm.
stuff, I would agree with this 100%, and I think I still agree with many of the things said.
Of course, I mean, behind the scenes,
mm-hmm.
someone is aware of these issues, and that's why that person making this kind of thing.
So
of course it's true,
true
but
true, true.
Of course, since we are not belong to that, not a citizen of that country
and society,
I don't want to say anything, but it's not just because it's America. In other countries there are also same issues, same
mm.
problems.
Mm.
So he spoke very well,
and I also like the part where he said if you don't know the problem you cannot even solve it. So
first step is
Anyway, that was America isn't the greatest country in the world anymore. Let us know what you guys think, actually, in the comment section. I'm intrigued. And we'll see you next time. Peace out.